The Power Factor Show with Rick, Steve, and Caleb. Episode 86.
You can find this podcast and others at Gun Rights Radio Network, gunrightsradio.com. Podcasting freedom.
Brought to you by Safariland
and Hodgson, the gunpowder people.
So we're here with John in his workshop, and John's gonna, because I tried to fit, I bought a Dawson adjustable sight and tried to fit it on my slide, but can't do it because there's a space that we need to
Well, what Loke said is, that's too much material for me to file.
as much I can do with that file, exactly.
And then I asked him, so how are you going to do this part that's going to be cut out and down low back here? And he choked for a minute.
Yeah. Buy a different file?
Yeah, okay.
Buy a different file, that would work.
That's always good.
Cool, so let's see how you do it, the master at work.
I don't know what the exact measurements are on this thing, because most times the sight that we're putting in is, it looks a lot like a Bomar.
Yeah.
But the dimensions are different.
Yeah.
In a standard Bomar, they want you to cut the flat where the bottom of the sight is going to be 1 inch back from the breech face. This is going to be forward of that mark, because I've had it out here, and eyeballed it, and I've had the calipers, but I don't have a definite measure for, measurement for it.
Let me just zoom in and take a look.
So we're going to get close. Okay, so what I have done already is set the slide up in the vise, and I've dialed it so this surface, where the old sight rested, is flat.
Okay.
I don't care what
that's
the
zero basically.
So that's zeroed. Mm-hmm. I also zeroed it for right to left, you know, as far as being true. So the sight is going to be across, or at least the cut I do is going to be straight across the slide. And you can't see it, but it's running from,
oh, I see there's a number on your dial there, right?
Yeah. Well, that doesn't mean anything.
I mean over here,
but,
right?
Yeah, but it's running about a tenth to two tenths of a thousandth out of
that
straight.
Display right there.
And that's plenty good for Loke.
Okay, yes. Exactly. I'm not making like a precision 5,000 meter shot.
So now we're going to get a cutter. We're going to set it up.
So you're installing the... So you're just doing one cut with that cutter?
I'll probably do a couple. I'm going to sneak up on where the front of it's going to be.
Okay.
Because I don't want to over.
You bring it back to zero, is that correct?
I don't care about that.
Oh, you don't care about that anymore? You're just eyeballing everything now.
What I want to do is use this under the cutter at the back, so I know I'm 2.5 thousandths off of it. Because I don't want to cut into this.
Oh, I see.
So and the front of it, theoretically, is at the same level.
Okay.
So there's all the little ledge on the front. Yep. We just want to take that and make it a big ledge.
Okay. That's a Kimber TLE RL2 slide, by the way.
Yeah, it used to be.
It used to be. Now it's going to be a custom JPL Kimber slide. I don't know if you want to put your name next to it. But
So I just want to get, like I say, close to it.
Just nice, so that you can move a little bit, yeah.
So I can move it. Mm-hmm. I know I'm not on it, so I want to zero this out.
So you got that zeroed, testing up the.
So I know eventually the front of this thing.
So you can see, John is eyeballing the location of the front of the sight. And John is adjusting the speed of the belt. Is it easy? It looks
well. This is it usually is. Career assignment. I've never had to do that before. that just fell off because you're here.
Ah, yes.
Everything goes. I'm to blame. When you're not here.
All right, let's set up for a different angle here. Is that touching 200?
That's two. So it could be like a half thou off. If I want to cut it there, and I'm going to get it all the way forward, I want to see how big a step I have. How big a step I have between the cut in front of the dovetail that's already there,
mm-hmm.
and, you know, what I end up with.
Okay. Okay. Are you making it move on its own?
It's smoother that way, and it's a constant feed rate rather than trying to spin it. So every time the cutter turns, it's going to cut the same amount with any luck at all.
Ouch.
I hope that's where we want it.
Not very reassuring. And when my gunsmith say, I hope that's where we want to cut.
Eyeball gunsmith.
That's pretty cool. I'm going to change the angle looking from this side.
Just go get your files out and do this.
Yeah. There's no turning back from this.
It's there now.
That's good.
There, now it's flaring for you, isn't it?
That's the Dawson Bomar-style target sights. And measuring the front.
That's pretty close.
Wow, lucky you didn't go 3.35, huh?
That's where I'm going to go now.
Okay.
But, you know, like we were talking before, it's nice to have it nice and tight and down flat, but you're going to end up with a little bit of daylight between the front of the sight body
mm-hmm.
and the slide, so that it'll tilt for you.
That, wait, let me see. Do that again.
Yeah.
Yeah, so the front would tilt up, right? Yeah, I can see that. Now that you've kind of cut the front up a little bit, let's see if it fits again. Yeah, so for this kind of size, it's fine, Danny, to measure the front. It's actually not the real front until you tip the top up, right? Because when you tip
it depends on the sight and the design, because this one is sticking out just a little bit.
Okay. So, I mean, if they put a radius on top, like a 45-degree cut, then maybe that would be fully flat, right? Not just...
Let's see if it wants to go in or not.
Nice.
Just like your house with the files.
Nice. That's just a sexy looking slide now.
Now, how far up will it go? It'll go that far.
Well, I think,
So we can move it a little bit further.
I think I don't need to take shots up to like 5 miles, right?
Well, no, I mean, as far as getting the screws and stuff inside of
yeah,
it.
Yeah, that's right.
It's got a set screw and then the springs. So I think I want to move it just a skosh more.
Cool. And then so you got to cut the back too, right?
Yeah, that's it. You want to come on this side, take a look at how close to the...
You're measuring the...
I'm measuring the width of the leaf.
Okay.
Not the blade, but the part in front of it. Because that's what is going to drop down inside the slide.
Mm-hmm.
So that's 703.
There's a lot of writing going on in gunsmithing, huh?
You need a big button calculator as you get older. So that's 703. And I want to have some clearance on either side of it, probably 10 or 15 thousandths. So I'm going to go like 723 is how wide I want to make that thing.
Okay.
And
because it's going to be a groove, isn't it? Not a. You're not taking the whole slide off. You're just cutting like a hole.
I'm cutting.
Yeah. I'm just going to show them the slide here. So in order to fit in here, he's going to cut a groove that's like U-shaped back here. And it sits lower. So that the sight, the top part of this, the back part of the sight will be able to sit flush against the slide. So he has to cut this part. He has to cut the firing pin stop as well.
We'll do that when we're done.
Yeah.
So we'll use this guy. And we'll take this guy
okay.
out.
All right.
And we don't need that level anymore because everything's changing now. We're also going to find where the middle of the slide is.
Mm-hmm.
And that'll be our zero, and then we're going to go right and left from that.
Nice.
Just like you do with your robots.
Yeah, exactly. Dead reckoning.
But I don't know about the dead part.
Yeah.
Their dovetail's like 100 thousandths deep,
mm-hmm.
but the leaf is down, I think it's like 135 on the print.
Right,
so and this that. Looks like it's just dead flat with 1-2-3 block. It's not quite.
Not quite.
Not quite.
By yeah, it's not quite. See some light. So we just do the calculation. There we go.
See how deep we're gonna go. My barrel fitting feeler cases.
So your gunsmithing is an exact science. Not much eyeballing and filing.
There's some guys that do. So that's like 13.
1300?
13,000.
13,000.
But I still want daylight under it.
Just a little bit, right?
Yeah. So now, we'll put the 1-2-3 block away. We'll put the feeler gauge away. Now we'll get the depth micrometer out to see how deep that dovetail really is.
Oh, so you're measuring
the depth.
The depth, I see.
From the flats, the factory flat, and then the one that we cut.
Correct.
That's where the bottom of the sight's going to be.
Correct. Instead of using a caliper like I would probably do.
That's not real accurate.
Yeah, that's not accurate at all, exactly.
That's a curse, precise.
Can you move your left hand?
Just to
see. Okay, there we go. So it's measuring the top and then
so I got
the bottom down.
I got the base of the micrometer. On either side.
Yeah.
And
then there's a rod that he pushes down, right?
Yep.
There we go. See, it comes down. And then you look at the whatever the number is.
And then you look at it and see, well, where did it go? So that's 100, 1.5.
Lots of calculating.
So I'm going to cut 93,000. I'm going to cut, I call it the well, where this part is going to go down inside the slide.
Yep.
I'm only going to cut that 93,000 deep.
Okay.
There's some problems.
So this one over here is the width of the... this.
That's the width of the leaf.
The leaf, correct. Right?
This part.
Correct.
Between my fingers.
Right. And the 186 is the width of the tool.
Right.
So you deduct this, you get the result, and divide by 2, that's the amount that you push
either,
in and you go left,
way.
Right.
Yeah.
Either way, just to make that clear. Right. Great.
Okay.
I went to school for a reason.
Said, as you just said, well, that's the theory anyway. So, 93 deep, plus or minus 270 when we get done.
Okay.
So now, we're going to go find the middle of that sucker.
Yeah.
And this is where the DRO gets really handy.
What's the DRO?
This thing, the numbers machine. Right there.
No, it's a crest for center. There.
Okay.
What does that do?
It wobbles, and then it doesn't, and then as soon as it does again,
that means it's
just went past center.
So, oh.
See it wobble now?
Okay. So it's wobbling, right?
So it's going to touch the flat, the side of the slide.
Okay.
And then it's going to straighten up.
Oh, I see. So once it stops, it means it's perfectly...
As soon as it's centered, it'll stop. And then you just want to keep going just until it breaks.
And then back it up a little bit. No.
You just call that zero.
Okay.
Come on. Now you want to break. You broke before.
There we go. V0. Cool.
Close enough.
It's at 449. You go in the middle of it.
That should be
dead center.
In the middle of the slide. And if you look straight down it, you'll see that, just for an eyeball check, that...
You gotta assume that Kimber put the hole exactly perfectly center.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, good luck with that.
Do you think? Does it look center?
Well, okay.
It looks okay.
Okay.
I guess.
So we'll go from there.
All right. Okay, so this is as center as you can get, right?
That's in the middle of the slide, and it's back, and I just picked a spot to stop it going forward.
Mm-hmm.
So it'll be just past the edge of this little window in here. And I'm going to touch it. Then we're going to zero this.
Mm-hmm.
And then we're going to bring it up about halfway. I'll probably bring it up 50 thousandths. And then I'll cut it. If we're going to go plus or minus 270, I'll probably go plus or minus 250 to make that first pass. And back it out and then bring it up the rest of the way.
Nice.
And then go all the way.
Okay.
So...
Bringing the table up slowly.
I just want to see just a little bit of a chip. So now we're going to zero this. We really want to go 93, so I'm going to come up 50.
Yeah. Well, it's 270, but you said you wanted to give it a test run.
Yeah. Well, because you're taking a lot of material out, and the tool's going to flex. Okay. So this is like hogging it out. And then on the
second run
one,
is more precise, right?
Yeah. And sometimes I'll even do like 250 when I bring it up, and then get it everything all hogged out, and then go back and make it, you know, the final dimension for the side. So 250... See, this is the part I'd like to see the files that you have.
I have a special file. And then just going back to zero on the screen, right?
Uh-huh. So I'm gonna run it down to zero and then go the other 250.
30, 20, 15, 10, 5, 0.
And now,
clean that stuff off.
Do this 250.
And then back out the...
It's like machine shop school. They give you numbers and then once you go hit it.
Yeah. And how do you cut the stuff out in the middle? It's going to go and...
Pardon me?
How are you going to cut the middle?
Glad you asked. Now we got that.
Like that. Brute force.
No, not too brute.
Here's where John plays Etch-a-Sketch.
So that is a start.
Okay.
So now we'll come up to 93.
The actual depth. Four. Oh, 93. There we go.
And then go to 2. 3, what?
We'll go up to 270, which is the actual cut where we want it. Okay, 270. There we go. Zero. I can totally do that with files, John.
I know.
Yeah.
But you got a Dremel tool, don't you?
Yeah. Yes, I can do that with my Dremel. Yeah, sure. Get my daughter to hold the Dremel up straight while I move the slide. Yeah. Totally. Totally do that. $265, $268, $269, tap, 270. Look at that. Can't even see it move on the actual slide. So do you have to use a special bit to cut hot chrome? Doesn't really matter.
These are carbide.
Carbide bits.
And I like carbide because you don't have to run coolant on them at the speeds that I run it.
Yeah.
And you can actually have, you know, a relatively clean shop space without coolant splattered all over
the place. How much are each of the bits? Are they really expensive?
Some of them are. Like I just broke something. These aren't real expensive. They're small. They're carbide. They're like 10, 12 bucks.
Not bad.
That's like 3/16.
Yeah.
So that looks good. So now we just have one more thing to take into account.
What? Fine pin stop?
Is the back of the blade is going to want to come down into some of this area.
Oh, yeah, that's right. So maybe you need to chop that off too, huh?
And again, Bomar... I keep walking away with this one. Bomar, on their print, I think it's something like 80 thousandths. I've been cutting them like at 100.
Okay. Let the leaf clear, right? Because that's slightly bigger than
that. That'll let the blade clear.
The blade.
Yes. Which is part of the leaf. Look at that.
Wow. Nice.
Look at that.
It fits perfectly, huh?
If where the firing pin safety wasn't full of chips, I'd just leave it in there. So we'll clean that up. And then, you got to raise it up. You should never be able, to get into that. But I hate burrs. And I have the scars to prove it.
Oh, yes.
I want to see how tall this is. Because 580. Your time and join the summer with family and friends. Family owned. Because that's how tall.
You shave the firing pin stuff.
I want to make this guy.
Yeah.
And he is 650 to 580. Must be what? 70?
Oh gosh. 650, 580? It's 470. 70.
That's right. We can check it.
You can check it with your calculator. That's true. We should probably do that.
And we haven't even been drinking.
Yeah. Are you going to cut it and then measure it?
I'm going to cut it and put it in.
Chopping up the firing pin stock so you match the height of the new sight. Oh, the new slide. Cut.
Thank you. Look at that.
Does it fit?
What do you mean, does it fit? Yes, it fits. You wouldn't be here if it didn't fit.
Of course it fit.
Right. So I think this goes in first. That goes in. I hate safety parts.
Well, I have to say, this is easier than the Series 80 safety.
Maybe.
No?
We'll see.
But there's so many levers on the Series 80.
Yeah. Scratching everything up.